Hello everyone, Teagan here with High Point Scientific. We want to thank you so much for tuning in to What is in the Sky this month, April edition. I will be taking you through a beautiful tour of the night sky in April. So as always, buckle up and let's see what's really out there. So first, we are going to journey millions and millions of light years past our own solar system and explore a trio of galaxies, Messier 65, Messier 66, and NGC 3628, otherwise known as the Leo Triplet. As many amateur astronomers know, spring is considered galaxy season. In this instance, we have the opportunity to see three shining examples right next to each other. Again, known collectively as the Leo Triplet, you can glimpse M65 and M66 within the same binocular field of view as Theta Leonis or Sheraton, but you'll need a scope to spot NGC 3628. A magnification of around 75 times will show you all three elongated patches, M65 being the brightest and NGC 3628 the faintest of the three. The Leo Triplet is a favorite among amateur astrophotographers, specifically NGC 3628. It is one of my favorite galaxies to image and is also known as Sarah's Galaxy. Next on our list is, of course, another galaxy, Messier 106. Located in the constellation of Canes Venetici, M106 is one of the brightest galaxies visible from the northern hemisphere. Unfortunately, there are no bright stars immediately nearby, so you'll have to hop over from Fecta in the Big Dipper to 5 Canum Veneticorum. So we have taken a look at some of the most iconic galaxies in the night sky in April from the northern hemisphere. Let's reel back and take a look at what the planets and the moon are up to. Neptune remains in Aquarius and is too close to the sun to be visible, but Mercury returns to the evening sky around mid-month. If you want to try your luck, look low over the western horizon from about 15 minutes after sunset. It will be in Aries when it first becomes visible, and then it crosses into Taurus on the 25th. Uranus is also in Aries, but is far too faint to be seen against the evening twilight. Venus, Mars, and Saturn start the month huddled together in Capricornus. You'll see them within the pre-dawn twilight, huddled together within the same binocular field of view on the 1st. Mars and Saturn draw closer together and will be less than a moon's width apart on April 3rd and April 4th. The planets will then be joined by the gas giant Jupiter around mid-month, with all four appearing equally spaced on April 18th. Like Mars and Saturn, Venus and Jupiter are drawing closer together and will be less than half a degree apart on the 30th. The waning crescent moon passes the four planets from the 24th to the 27th, providing a beautiful sunrise view. It turns new on the 1st, and Luna turns full on the 16th, and then new again on the 30th. So before we head out into deep space once again, we're going to stay within our solar system, and we're going to check out an event happening within the constellation of Lyra, the Lyrid meteor shower. It's been a while since we've had a major meteor shower to look forward to, but luckily the month of April has come to show us the spectacular Lyrids. They peak in the early hours of the 22nd, with around 18 meteors being visible under ideal conditions. The Lyrids get their name from the constellation of Lyra, which is where they appear to originate in the sky. Lyra rises a few hours before midnight on the 21st, with the moon following about 4 hours later. Now, these meteors can be fast but bright, and there's also a chance that you could see a bright fireball or two. So as promised, we are leaving our solar system and heading out into deep space to check out a beautiful star cluster, Malat 111. This scattering of stars can be found roughly midway between the stars Denebola in Leo and Corcoroli in Canes Venatici. You should be able to glimpse it with the naked eye under dark skies, but otherwise the cluster is best seen through binoculars or a very low-powered eyepiece. The cluster represents the hair of the Egyptian queen Berenice, which in turn gives the constellation its name, Coma Berenices, or Berenice's hair. This makes the constellation the only one named for an actual historical figure. So now we travel on to our last deep sky object of our tour in the month of April, Messier 97, the Owl Nebula. You'll find the Owl Nebula just 2.25 degrees from Merak, one of the stars that outline the bowl in the Big Dipper. It is possible to spot it with binoculars, but it is best to use a telescope. A small telescope at low power will show a faint dark circular patch, while a large scope can show you the eyes that give the nebula its name. If you're not having any luck, try an O3 filter to enhance the contrast between the nebula and the background sky. So that is it for our tour of the night sky in April. We thank you so much for tuning in tonight. If you have any questions, please let us know in the comments below, or you can reach out to us at highpointscientific.com, and our non-commissioned product advisors will be more than happy to assist you. Again, thank you so much for tuning in and joining us on this tour of the night sky in April. Clear skies.